Welcome back. It's time for a CNBC TV 18 exclusive. American e-commerce giant Amazon is set to pick up to 8% stake in India's future retail. Sources say that the deal is expected to be announced within 2 weeks. Priya Seth has all the details. Priya, what are you picking up about the likely contours of this arrangement?
Well, after 8 months of negotiation, we understand that the future retail Amazon deal has entered its last lap. Now, the deal is likely to be signed over the next 2 weeks, is what our sources tell us. Now, tech giants, including the likes of Google and Paytm, had expressed interest to buy a stake as far as future retail goes. But Amazon is likely to have emerged as a front runner, is what our sources tell us. Now, just to give you a specific on the deal, about 7 to 8% is likely to be the kind of stake Amazon is looking to buy as far as future retail is concerned, and the companies are in final stages of preparing an agreement. They could also look at including some exclusivity clauses as a part of this overall agreement. Valuations will be decided closer to the deal signing, but of course the deal is definitely going to be a part cash, part stock deal, is what we are given to understand. Now, as far as the synergies of the deal are concerned, it could be a win-win for both the companies. As far as Amazon is concerned, they could look at setting up a separate microsite for future retail brands, while Amazon experience zones could be set up in several of the future retail stores across the country. In fact, we did reach out to the companies concerned, and future retail did not respond to our query, while Amazon said that it did not want to comment as far as our query is concerned.
And weeks before this news break, Future Group's Kishore Biyani had hinted at a potential tie-up with a global company, with Walmart and Flipkart joining hands. Biyani had said it is imperative to have a strong balance sheet, and also went on to say that he's open to a partnership with a global retail company.
I don't know what will happen, but ecosystem will get formed. There will be three, four...
So you're not averse to the idea?
Nobody is averse to any idea. Money is
welcome. Earlier you used to be.
I never said money is not welcome.
No, you never said money was not welcome, but you always had an ambivalent attitude when it came to FDI.
I'm still very nationalistic on everything.
You're very nationalistic on everything, but you're open to partnering with Amazon if it comes down.
I think in this business, if you don't have a good and a strong balance sheet, you don't win.
It's not going to be an easy road for the Fortis IHH healthcare deal, as the Competition Commission of India has raised red flags about the deal structure. In an exclusive conversation with CNBC TV 18's Yash Jain, the chairperson of Competition Commission, Sudhir Mittal, has said that approval delay will have an economic impact. Here's an excerpt of that conversation.
The commission has been quite conscious of the fact that delays, if any, have economic impact on the parties, and so we would not wish to keep it for long one way or the other. Either we approve it, or in case we have concerns, we tell the parties that these are the concerns that you need to answer.
From what you've been studying the entire model, do you see concerns at this point of time as we talk?
As of now, there appear to be some concerns. Well, we are in constant discussions, and they have given their reply, so let's see. I mean, it may not be proper for me to be commenting till such time as we've taken a decision.
Okay. If you could throw some light on the kind of concerns, not going into the details, but what are broadly these concerns?
The way the markets work is, and the health sector is, that you have the primary market, you have the secondary market, you have the tertiary market, and then you have the super specialty market.
Right.
So it's basically, the concerns are not in the primary market or the secondary market or the tertiary market. If concerns, as we perceive them, probably would be in the super speciality market.
The commission had raided a few premises of some of the breweries, famous breweries.
Right.
Help me understand, what was the line of thought? What are the points of suspicion as far as, you know, these companies are concerned? And how far has the whole inquiry and understanding gone on the commission's part?
What I can only mention at this point of time, that we had a feeling that these companies are or have cartelized in terms of tenders to the government, and that's what we really wanted to investigate.
And how far is
time? There's no. Well, the dawn raids have been conducted. material has been collected.
Okay.
So I think there should be enough till now.
What is the essential case as far as Monsanto is concerned, and where do you see this moving going forward?
What Monsanto had said was that the commission could not investigate the conduct of the directors at the same time as it was investigating the conduct of the company.
Right.
So the court, of course, has said that no, the commission can is free to conduct to under Section 48 to simultaneously conduct an inquiry.
Right. And how? What stage is the inquiry, and how does it flow from
well,
here?
It's before the Director General.